Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you transmission path loss equation. To derive transmission path loss equation, one should know Friis transmission formula. See, in my last video, I have derived Friis transmission formula, that is PR by PT, where PR is received power by antenna and PT is transmitted power by antenna. So PR by PT, that is GTGR divided by 4 pi d by lambda whole square. Here, see this GT, that is gain of transmitting antenna, and GR is gain of receiving antenna. Here, see this distance D is distance in between transmitting and receiving antenna. And this wavelength lambda, that is wavelength of transmitted EM wave over here. Right, so Friis transmission formula, that is PR by PT, that is equals to GTGR divided by 4 pi d by lambda whole square. Using this equation, we will be calculating transmission path loss. So let me note down that equation of Friis transmission formula first. So Friis transmission formula is ratio of received power divided by transmitted power of antenna, that is GT GR divided by 4 pi d by lambda whole square. Now to get transmission path loss, we will be considering this equation in form of dB, right? To have this equation in form of dB, we will be taking 10 log at both of this side. Once you take this equation in form of dB, now we can apply property of log over here. So here in this equation, on this side, we have 10 log of PR by PT. That is, now you see here we have GT and GR in multiplication. So we can write 10 log of GT plus 10 log of GR. And here 4 pi d by lambda whole square, that is there in division. So we can write minus 10 log of 4 pi d by lambda whole square. Now we can further simplify this equation, where you can take this 2 in front over here, right? So in this equation, now over here with this term, we will be having minus 20 log of 4 pi d by lambda only, right? So here we are taking this 2 in front. So this will become 20 log of 4 pi d by lambda, right? Now here with this equation, see this much term that is negative means this much term that belongs to spatial transmission loss. So this much term that belongs to spatial transmission loss. Based on this transmission attenuation loss, we can derive transmission path loss equation, right? So let me take this term separately, which is loss term over here. So this L of S, that is spatial transmission loss, right? So this L of S, that is 20 log of 4 pi d by lambda. L of S, that is 20 log of 4 pi d by lambda, right? Now we need to represent this equation in bit simplified version, where I'll be representing this equation in form of frequency. So here one should know lambda is having relation with frequency c. Here frequency f, that is equals to c by lambda. So you can say lambda, that is equals to c by f, where value of C is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, right? So we can represent lambda in form of frequency. So now this equation will get changed. You see how. Now L of S, that will be 20 log of, now instead of this lambda, I'll be writing 3 into 10 to the power 8, and this F will go in numerator. So into D into F, that will be there with us, right? Now, with this equation, we need some further simplification. So here, what I'll be doing is, I'll be representing this distance in form of kilometer. The reason is usually we use transceiver system for long distance communication. So I'll be considering distance in form of kilometer, and I'll be considering this frequency in form of megahertz. So here, see, in this equation, what we'll be doing is, we'll be considering this part of equation, which is distance into frequency, that is there in form of kilometer. So if I consider this in form of kilometer, then just multiply it with 10 to the power 3. And if you consider this frequency in form of megahertz, then just consider this in 10 to the power 6. Right. So now here we have this much term into distance in form of kilometer and frequency in form of megahertz. Right. Now we can further simplify this equation, in which you see how this loss, that is equals to 20 log of, now you see 4 pi divided by 3 is there, and here 10 to the power 9 divided by 10 to the power 8 means into 10 is there, and this is there in multiplication. So we can represent further terms as per plus 20 log of distance in form of kilometer plus 20 log of frequency in form of megahertz, right? If you solve this in calculator, then you will be getting this much term, that is 32.44 in form of dB plus 20 log of distance in form of kilometer plus 20 log of frequency in form of megahertz. And this is equation which is of transmission path loss equation, where distance is there in form of kilometer and frequency is there in form of megahertz. So as and when you have been given with distance in between two antenna, and as and when frequency of transmission is given, then how much loss is happening, that is purely based on distance and frequency as per this equation. And this equation, that is there in form of loss with respect to dB, right? It is not value, it is there in form of dB, right? So that is how one can calculate loss because of distance and frequency, right? So this is the basic equation which we wanted to derive, and based on this equation, in future we'll be solving some interesting examples, right? So here, see, this Friis transmission equation, that is very much essential in solving equations, as well as transmission path loss equation. This transmission path loss equation, that is depending on distance and frequency, this equation is also essential for solving questions. So you should remember these two equations for solution of problems. I hope you have understood this video. Still, if anything that you'd like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.